Oh, good morning, family. Did anyone else get hail? Yeah. My wife texts me, says, we're getting hail. I'm like, cool. I like weather phenomenon. I'm still waiting to see my first tornado. I mean, I've seen them on TV, and I'm all right if they're from a distance, but I've never seen a tornado. This has nothing to do with church. Would you stand here? All right. Oh, weather. This is the day the Lord has made, even if it's raining and hailing and snowing, which we'll eventually get here, but we'll hold off on that because I still haven't gone on a color tour. So. We live in a state that is just beautiful. Amen. We are blessed to live where we live. And getting up in the morning, it's kind of transitioning into watching the stars still. You know, by the time we get up, I was like, oh, these sunrises are pretty. But now it's like, wow, these stars are pretty when I wake up. But we live in a place where our night skies are just amazing. And when I was in the Navy on our ship, you know, I probably told you guys a couple times, my nighttime routine after, you know, dinner and all that and cleaning up, I would go lay down on the bow of the ship. And I would just lay down and listen to the water hit. And at night, I mean, here, night skies are awesome. Middle of the ocean is amazing. And I would think of this song that we're going to start out with. It's, you know, how great thou art. Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars. And I see the stars and the stars. And I hear the rolling thunder. But what we're doing with this hymn, we're doing it, and it's just a little tempo, so it's a song you know, how great thou art. But we encourage you, clap your hands, all you people. That's scriptural. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout out to God with a voice of triumph. Oh, Lord, my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display.
Come on now.
Then sings my soul. Son, not sparing, sent him to die. I scarce can take it in that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin.
Sing it with me.
Then sings my soul. My Savior.
and how great thou art. How great thou art. You may be seated. Well, welcome to church. Aren't you thankful for a chance to gather together with other Christ followers under the authority of our Savior and worship Him? God is good. He loves you with an everlasting love, and He calls you near to Himself. And this morning is part of that invitation, that by God's grace we can come into His presence, hear from Him, and respond to Him, worship Him, offer ourselves to Him, get some things right with Him. Right? Maybe there's some things that were a part of your life this last week or maybe even this morning, who knows, that you know isn't what God intends for you. And you could lay that down this morning. You leave that with Him this morning. Ask Him to forgive you and cleanse you and walk out renewed with a new start in the presence of our God. We'd like to ask you to fill out a Connect card at some point during your service today. And we had ordered a bunch of Connect cards from a new company because the other company that we had used over the years wasn't available. And we got high-gloss finish cards. And I heard some feedback and experimented myself, and they were almost ink-proof, you know, those high-gloss cards we had. Well, just know that Brandy Sikorsky took painstaking amounts of time and removed all those because we ordered matte cards, and those are in all the seat backs now. So if you gave up on writing out prayer requests because you were on the brink of losing your salvation out of frustration, they now can be written upon. Praise the Lord. And so grab the Connect cards, make sure you let us know you were here, fill those out, use those anytime for updated information, feedback, comments, and most critically, prayer. When you fill those out, you can drop them in the offering baskets. If this is your first time with us this morning, bring your card just over on the toward the coat rack here where you head out. There's a table on the right-hand side under the gather sign, and we have a gift we'd like to give you. If you bring your card over and just say hi to us, and just thank you for being here. And so please take advantage of that. A couple things to call to your attention out of the bulletin. The bulletin's always filled with so many opportunities to connect with God in deeper ways through faith in Christ, to connect with other people that are on this journey, heading in the same direction. So please consider ways to get connected. A couple things I wanted to call your attention to. Today, immediately following this service, we are doing one of our Keeping Kids Safe courses. This course is a requirement for those who are involved in any kind of ministry at any level with minors. So if you participate in any kind of ministry with those under 18, you need to go ahead and take this course. If you already have taken it, then you've had that training and you've met that requirement. But if you haven't yet, please consider staying after this service. Or if you can't, but you need to, you can see me after service, and I will make connection then with the children's ministry leaders to make sure you get that training. But we're offering that today after this service. Where will that training be? Room 20. Okay, thank you. So room 20 is a large classroom all the way through the gym. If you keep walking past the kitchen and run into a wall, you're in room 20. All right? That's where we're doing the training. Also, just take note of some of the fun activities coming up. In just a few Wednesdays from now, on October 30th, we're having our fall family gathering, which we always do a chili cook-off, lots of games and activities for kids and families, and we're going to have a great time together that night. So if you are willing to enter into the friendly chili cook-off competition, we'd love to have you sign up in the sign-up station in the gym on the left-hand side as you walk in. Let us know you're able to supply a chili, even if you don't care about the competition. We'd still love to have your chili, just because we usually need about probably 30 crock pots of chili to feed everybody that night. We have hundreds of people that come out, and so if you're willing to be a part of that, that is great. Bella Sikorsky, just a little blonde-haired girl about that tall, is our reigning champion from last year, and I'm hearing she's already gearing up for another run this year. And so test your chops against Bella Sikorsky, because she's our reigning champ, and then we'll have a good time with that competition again this year.
It's on, Bella. It's on.
All right. Well, this time I'd like to invite you to, you know what, let me announce one other thing. I did it later in the service, last service, but I'd like to do it now before I forget. We had the honor of hosting the first quiz meet, the Bible quiz meet, to open the season yesterday here at this church. And so we had our Ogemaw Hills teams take on the other teams from Michigan and Ohio. And I just have a little report to read from Terry Durfee, our quiz team leader, our quiz ministry leader. She said, "What an amazing first day of quizzing for this year. We hosted the first tournament here, and we have a total of 14 quizzers on our teams this year, tackling 1st and 2nd Corinthians. We had four teams competing today. Our senior teen veteran team of Faith, Corey, and Devin took third place, bringing home a trophy. Young teen veteran team of Amelia, Anastasia, and Lily took fourth place. Young teen rookie team of Ella, Sadie, and Madison took second place and brought home a trophy. The young teen rookie team of Caitlin, Natalie, and Connor took fourth place. We also had Ella place third in individual competition, and Devin took third in his division in individual competition. Connor, Corey, and Devin quizzed out, meaning they answered the maximum amount of questions they were allowed to in a quiz, and they received a quiz out ribbon. And Ella quizzed out three times in her first tournament ever. 11 of our quizzers received their quote ribbons, having memorized everything they needed to for this first tournament. And she said, "It's a God-filled day of fun, laughter, and teens quoting God's word." And also she wrote a note of thanks. "We'd like to thank all our church family who helped make this such a successful day. Keep praying for all these teens that they can apply what they are learning to their everyday life. Blessings, Terry." So we praise the Lord for a great opening tournament and that our church was able to host that and all the behind-the-scenes work that went into making that happen. And I know for a fact, because I made a donation and pilfered the baked good table very, very late last night. There are baked goods down there. Are there still baked goods left from after first service? So there's baked goods down there still available to support the quizzers going to nationals this summer, just one little fundraiser they're doing, and they have some leftovers from the tournament yesterday. So before you leave, purchase some calories in the name of young people learning the Word of God, right? There's no better cause to get fat for. So grab some desserts and take those with you and be a blessing to the students with the donations you make. Now will you stand with me at this time as we pray and prepare our hearts to enter into worship before the Lord. God, we thank you. We thank you that you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. You're the God who parted the Red Sea. You're the God who's raised the dead back to life. Lord, you're the one who saves souls and sets people free. And you're here today as we gather in your name. So, Lord, we want to worship you with all our heart. We want to express to you what you mean to us. And so, Lord, won't you meet us here? We thank you for this opportunity to praise your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The first song we're singing, if you look up on the words, you'll see holy, holy, holy. I just want to let you know it is not, you know, there's the hymn, holy, holy, holy. It's a very beautiful hymn, very traditional hymn. This is not that hymn. Instead of holy, holy, it's more of a holy, holy, holy. So, again, I'm not saying you have to, but if you want to move your feet, you can move your feet. If you want to clap your hands, clap your hands. If you want to raise your hands, and we get to that part, and it's praise him and lift him up. Whose job is it to lift him up? That's us. Let's lift him up.
He is. Holy is
Come on, here we go.
So let's praise him. Mm-hmm. Praise him and lift him up. Praise him. Exalt his name forever. 'Cause he's holy, holy, holy. Holy, holy.
Praise him and lift him up. He said, if I be high and lifted up, I would draw him in unto me. And it's our job to raise and lift up the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Isaiah says, I saw the Lord. He was seated on a throne, exalted, and the train of his robe filled the temple. And he heard the angel singing what we just sang, holy, holy is the Lord. I see the Lord and his train fills the temple. I see the Lord, he is high and lifted up. Say it again, I see the Lord. I see the Lord, and his train fills the temple, or the glory of the Lord. I see the Lord, he is high and lifted up. And angels cry, and angels cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Angels cry, holy, holy is the Lord. I see the Lord in his eyes a flaming like fire. I see the Lord, and his hair is white as snow. Angels cry, and angels cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Angels cry, came and touch the cold to my lips. And now my guilt is gone, and my sin has been forgiven. And I cry, and I cry, holy, holy is the Lord. And I cry, holy, holy is the Lord. And the temple is filled. And the temple is filled with the glory of God. And the whole earth, and the whole earth is filled with the glory of God. And the temple is filled. And the temple is filled with the glory of God. He called to me, whom shall I send? I answered him, I will go for you. And I cry, and I cry. And I cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Sing it, church, and I cry. And I cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Let's sing that again, and I cry. And I cry, holy, holy is the Lord. Let him hear you, church, and I cry. And I sing it again. Sing it to him. And I cry. And I holy is the Lord, the one who was and is to come, soon to come. We praise you, Lord. Lord, we'd seen you move. Move in your church, move in your people. Thank you for testimonies of saints that have gone before, Lord. But we don't just want the glory and the stories of old. Lord, create in us new testimonies, new miracles. You can do it again. Not that you have to perform for us, Lord, but use us through you. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but you have never failed me yet. Waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet. I know the night won't last. Your word will come to pass. My heart will sing your praise again. Jesus, you're still enough. Keep me within your love. My heart will sing your praise again. Your promise. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness, faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed. Yeah. Come on, petition God. I've seen you move the mountains, and I believe, I see you do it again. You made a way where there was no way, and I believe, I see you do it again. I've seen you move the mountains, and I believe. Church, your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness,
faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You never failed me. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. I'm still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet.
Lord, you could never fail. Lord, you're perfect, you're everlasting, you're infinite. Lord, you know everything. You're all powerful. You're everywhere. Lord, you could never fail. God, help me, help us not to fail you. And Lord, if I'm left to my own, it's an absolute guarantee that I'm going to fall flat on my face. Lord, we thank you this morning for your amazing grace. We thank you, Lord, for your mercy that you say in your word that's new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. Your faithfulness to call us near to yourself. Your faithfulness to touch us with your grace. That smile that you have toward us that we could never deserve. That power that you move in among us. Lord, to be able to fulfill your intentions and your will. Lord, we thank you. You are faithful and true. May we walk in that faithfulness and walk in your truth. We love you, Lord. And we give ourselves to you in entirety. And God, as we give in just a moment, we give out of a heart filled with gratitude. We give out of worship. We don't give to get anything from you. We give because you deserve our everything. And so, Lord, won't you receive this offering as a statement of praise and worship as well? May it be pleasing in your sight as we give by faith and use this offering as you see fit. Lord, we respond to you to be used of your work according to your purposes now and forever. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.